Hi, this is Eber from Minute Earth, and over the years, we have illustrated lots and lots of evolutionary trees. Some have been easy to make since they are already available, but sometimes we had to construct them from the ground up. For example, for this video, we needed a family tree that had diverse species, such as primates, sea creatures, amphibians, marsupials, etc. In this other, we needed to show the evolutionary relationship between dinosaurs, the Dimetrodon, and humans. So there should be an app for that, right? One that shows their relationship between specific species and allows you to explore any branch you're interested in. I cried for help on Twitter, and though I got some interesting replies and apps, none of them combined the features I was looking for. I soon lost hope of finding a tool like the one I envisioned, but couldn't forget about it since we were encountering more and more family trees in our work. At this point, there was only one option: build it ourselves. And so we did. I got in touch with the Minute Labs coding wizard Jasper, and a few months later, we came up with a Tree of Life Explorer. When you go to the Tree of Life Explorer, you will be welcomed with this screen. You will get an invitation to take a tour, but we are skipping it for now. The homepage displays several examples to start with. Let's choose our cousins. The tree is made up of cards. There will be a card for every single species displaying, when possible, their common name, their scientific name, and a picture. Clicking on the View button will show more information. You'll see the number that uniquely identifies that particular species and links to Wikipedia, the Open Tree of Life, and other taxonomic sites. You'll notice that every node, or taxon, has a card too, one for all of great apes, one for orangutans, and so on. Clicking here will display all the members of a particular taxon, or its descendants, if there are any. These other three show humans and cats. These numbers represent the amount of ancestors between cards. You can display them or hide them. You can also construct a tree from the ground up by going home and searching by common names, but you'll soon find out that humans are not very creative with names. So knowing the scientific name of what you're looking for is always an advantage. On the top right, there are a few more tools: undo, redo, change the orientation of the tree, and even share your favorite trees with other people. Finally, there's a link with more information about this project and how to support Minute Labs. After all these years, I cannot believe that this tool now exists. When I first talked with Jasper, I wasn't even sure it would be possible.
You know what, Ever? I wasn't sure either. There was no way we'd be able to input all the data ourselves, since there are just so many different species and so much data that's always being refined by the most recent studies. Fortunately, I discovered that the Open Tree of Life project has a publicly accessible API to get the data from. So I started with that and built some prototypes that used the data. So far so good, but I wanted a way to search for species by their common name: cat, dog, lion, human. And I also wanted to show images for each of the species if possible. But the Open Tree of Life didn't have either of these things built into their API, so what I ended up having to do was to tap into the GBIF search service for common name searching, and use Wikidata and Wikimedia for image results. It was tricky to merge all these data sources together, but after pulling my hair out a bit, I got it working well enough to be usable, even if it's not perfect. We learned a bunch of interesting things about evolution, species, and how we study them while building this app. Like, for example, the common names we use for some animals sometimes conceal the reality of their evolutionary history and variation. We've actually made another video on Minute Earth going into the details, so you should check it out. You can look at the code for this project on GitHub, which is the best place for reporting bugs. If you're interested in the geeky details of how I built this, like what data sources I'm using, what JavaScript frameworks, and so on, I'd be willing to do a code run-through if there's enough interest. If that sounds appealing to you, let me know in the comments, or head over to Patreon and leave a note there. And, of course, more importantly, head over to minutelabs.io and play around with the Tree of Life Explorer. We'll see you soon with something new.